deciding what to eat can be a real headache, and not just when you're choosing from a menu. Nowadays, we're bombarded with food-related do's and don'ts. Diet plans ranging from the fashionable yet dubious to the frankly dangerous, and scientific advice that seems to change on a weekly basis. The effect can be overwhelming, and given how important diet is, the stakes are high. But while it might seem like the answer to the question, "What should I eat?" depends on who you ask, the reality might be that it depends on who you are, at least according to the emerging field of personalized nutrition. Now, there are certain things all human bodies need. Vitamin C to prevent scurvy, for instance, or vitamin D for rickets. But when it comes to the big three, protein, carbohydrate, and fat, the key is finding the right balance. And that's harder than you might think. First, all bodies are different, meaning the right balance is slightly different for each of them. But second, that balance changes over time, as our internal processes are affected by sleep, exercise, age, and any number of other factors. So what your body needed last week, month, or year might not be what it needs today. Clearly then, while some nutritional advice is universal, exactly the same approach isn't going to work for everyone. But the thinking goes, if we can gain a better understanding of what makes each individual unique, we can tailor their dietary advice. And here, we've been making progress. The first step to unraveling this uniqueness lies in our understanding of genetics. With the completion of the Human Genome Project in 2003, we're now able to link specific genes to the way bodies respond to different foods. From how efficiently you burn through carbohydrates, to whether that mid-afternoon coffee will keep you up all night. But more than this, genetics also indicate how at risk we are of developing certain medical conditions, like diabetes, obesity, and heart disease, which is useful information to have when deciding what to eat, given that these conditions are all closely linked to diet. But as important as genetics are to this story, they don't explain everything. Our bodies play host to trillions of microorganisms, a diverse array of bacteria, viruses, fungi, and more, collectively known as the microbiome. This mini ecosystem plays an important role in many areas of our body's day-to-day functioning. And in the gut, this includes things like digesting food and synthesizing vitamins. So understanding the unique makeup of each person's microbiome is a big piece of the personalized nutrition puzzle. And now, thanks to the Human Microbiome Project, it's possible to send off a sample to a lab that will find out exactly what's in there, what it's doing, and what it needs more of. Today, companies are using these methods, combined with information from wearable technologies like fitness trackers and blood glucose monitors, and feeding the resulting data through machine learning algorithms to draw up a personalized nutritional profile intended to tell you, and you alone, what's best to eat. In some cases, they're also using customer data to check and improve their models, with some startling early results showing just how diverse people's reaction to food can be, even in cases where we wouldn't expect to see much variation, like in identical twins, and suggesting that following a personalized nutrition program can have tangible health benefits. Great as this all is, though, there are still grounds for caution. The fact that food is, quite literally, an everyday thing can lead us to believe there's nothing especially complicated about it. But in reality, nutrition is a complex field on its own. So combining it with genetics and microbiomics, neither of which is exactly straightforward, makes for one of the hardest problems in science. That's before we then try to apply those findings to billions of unique bodies around the world. So while we are making progress, it's important to be realistic about how much we still have to learn before we fully understand the complex relationships our bodies have with the food we eat. With that in mind, the accuracy some personalized nutrition companies are promising is, to be frank, more than they can reliably deliver. But maybe cutting-edge science isn't all personalized nutrition is bringing to the table. Obviously, making well-informed choices about our food is really important. But eating better is about more than just understanding the human body. It also involves the human mind. Many of us already know we'd benefit from more vegetables or less sugar, but that alone isn't necessarily enough to make it happen. When personalized nutrition programs target the individual, though, they don't just do it with biological data. They also offer support, education, and accountability. And that personalization could make the difference, helping people stick to their individually tailored diets, even if much of the actual nutrition advice turns out to be basically the same stuff we've been hearing for decades.